kind of on time and not off this conversation.
It's like being in the Olympics.
Yeah. But it's very useful. Yeah?
Very useful. I'm going to talk about part of my work, which has to do with territories and certain aspects of territories. I think this is the piece that sort of triggered this part of my work. It's called Diwinsa, and it it refers to a very specific border conflict between Ecuador and Peru that was after 40 years or 40 some years of military conflict. It ended in an amicable resolution by which the guarantors that were selected to mediate between the two countries decided to go for the Peruvian thesis of the border, and as a consolation prize they gave a kilometer square of Peruvian jungle to Ecuador, and this is a 1,000-to-1 scale part of that little jungle. The full title of this piece is Tiwinsa Monabul. It started with this absurdity of the references and of the border conflicts, and by doing this, I started doing a series of pieces in the places that I was showing that had to do with specific border conflicts. And this is another example. This was done for a 2008 show in Costa Rica in Teoretica, and this piece is called Acta de Canje, or Letter of Exchange, which is actually, you see in television, you see dignitaries when they're signing things, they sign the last letter and they actually exchange it, and that seals the deal. And this was in reference to a border conflict between Costa Rica and Nicaragua, related to the use of the river San Juan in Teoretica, and this piece is called Acta de Canje, or Letter of Exchange, which is actually, you see in television, you see dignitaries when they're signing things, they sign the last letter and they actually exchange it, and that seals the deal. And this was in reference to a border conflict between Costa Rica and Nicaragua, related to the use of the river San Juan. And this is truly the acta de canje, the letter of exchange, that has been cut into this eternal string of letters and words, and created this sort of bridge between these two countries. So this is, and from this I sort of, from this kind of series of words that I was dealing with, very specific border conflicts, I kind of asked myself the question, what was the origin of these things in my part of the world? I asked myself the question, what were the, in the conquest of the Americas, what were the, how did the European powers came to the Americas or wherever else in the world, but my concern with the Americas, and basically said, this is mine. And to be able to do that in whatever level, in a personal level or as a country, is actually incredibly powerful, and incredibly difficult, and incredibly daring act. So I started sort of trying to understand what were the rituals and the ceremonies that each of the five European countries that conquered the Americas, what were they doing to actually say, this is mine, and to claim those territories and to declare them their property. When I was doing all this research, I was lucky to, there's a photograph missing. Well,
describe it.
I was invited to the Venice Biennale in 2007, and what I did there, we were showing, the Latin American pavilion was showing in a building that was built at exactly the same time as the Spanish conquest to the Americas. And what I did there is a knife. It's a knife that is actually embedded on the wall, and it is written on the blade. It says, "Amo mio este territorio," I made this territory mine. And you can read this inscription only as a reflection on this very large, large wall. I don't know what happened to the image, I apologize. And sort of I started doing all this rich research on what this countries, what each of the countries were doing, what the French were doing, and what the English were doing. The English were very much into fences and planting. This is actually a project done in Germany, but I wanted to use the English version of property. And because they were so much into fences and the planting of things and the division between what is barbaric and non-barbaric territory. And then but I was also dealing with territory in sort of a different level, which was the personal level of this story, which is this piece is, it is what it says, like you do as I say, and it can again be seen as a political thing in a large context of countries. Tyrants love to use this phrase, but also in a personal level. And going to the rituals of possessions of territories, we come to this piece, which is actually shown in the stand here. And this refers to, I did it for the Mercosur Milan, so I was actually concentrating my attention on what the Portuguese did to say, this is mine. And their understanding of that was actually a scientific discovery. It's fascinating how the Portuguese, in a very short time, 40 years or 60 years, it was a concentration of knowledge for whatever historical reasons. I need to go long enough for that. And there is a wonderful story, it's a wonderful letter that was written by a Portuguese when he lands in Brazil, and he takes out one of the main instruments of navigation, which is the astrolabe, and he actually measures the latitude of Brazil and he sends a letter to the King of Portugal. And that gesture is actually the basis of claim of that territory. And this is my own interpretation of that dot of light that is created by an astrolabe that actually goes into the possession of all these territories. And the project that I'm doing here, I don't have images, you can go and see it around the corner. It's actually all these instruments of navigation. So I became fascinated by all these things that were being developed to answer a very basic questions, a practical question, which is where I am, where I'm going, and where I am in the middle of an enormous ocean and I'm not exactly know my direction, and how am I going to go back if I ever need to. And therefore, all these things that are, I always start with historical understandings, have obviously a very autobiographical, but also an answer to a lot of questions of what Pablo was saying of what is the art, the role of an artist. And the instruments that you can see here in the booth are instruments of navigation. They have a use. They are not sculptures. They are objects that have a use, or they have a lack of use. And they are all living in this world of finding your path or losing your path or locating from somewhere to another. And I think my time is up. Thank you. Thank
you. I think we don't have much time ourselves, Mark. So I think what at least I intended to present with these five projects and other six that we have there is maybe a different instruments of navigation. So I think that's a good way to put it together, more than represent nationality or regions. And I think a lot of the role of the artist is to examine how these borders have been built, also to dissolve them. So I think that's a nice part of the role that we do. I would prefer if